I think it was the new president of Drexel at the time. Was his name was Hagerty?
Yeah.
They asked me if I was interested in becoming dean of the school library, information science.
I didn't know that one.
Yeah, and I said, well, I might, but then it turns out that I said to him, well, that would be a part-time job, right? He said, oh, no, you basically, so you'd have to give up your company to do it. I said, when Carl Djerassi was asked to be chairman of the department, they didn't ask him to give up his stock in his company. And I don't intend to give up my work at ISI in order to do this, but it's a job that I think I could do, if you were interested in talking about it, as a, I wouldn't consider it a full-time job, but certainly I can handle it. And it never occurred to him that I might not be interested in just leaving the company. It's just another job, I guess, to him. But the teaching part never. They never did. During the times when some of the more conservatives never asked me to come over there and teach. It's very strange, I thought. And then later on, they gave me an honorary degree, but they never thought it was important enough for me to come over there and do any teaching. But there's some kind of a mindset there, I guess, about that. Now, the people at the Moore School, they were interested in getting these government contracts in the early days, and they wanted to, they wanted to know what information retrieval was. There was just a good coincidence that Saul Gorn was an old friend of Sam Lazerow that I had met when he was when I was still in Baltimore, and he was working at the Aberdeen Proving Grounds. I think he was a brilliant mathematician, and basically the father of programming languages. I think is what they considered him. He was a guru of that sort of thing. And he spoke to Morris Rubinoff at the Moore School, and then they said, oh, gee, why don't you come over and give this course for our graduate students in information retrieval? And that's how I got to doing the teaching at Penn. And I think I mentioned that when I was telling about the business about the information engineers, how it was okay to teach, but it was not okay to practice. And well, that always proved to be an interesting experience.